This is an update on the greenhouse. As you can see, all my plants are quite advanced in the season. But they looks like they are happy to be here. This is an hybrid I made. It's a Saracenia stevensi that looks almost like a Leucophylla. This is another one of my hybrids. This is a Saracenia oreophylla mixed with e Saracenia Leucophylla. This is a complicated one. I called this hybrid Saracenia Tempesta Nera, which means black storm in Italy, because it tends to get a black color, especially in autumn. And this is a complicated mix, I don't quite remember at the moment. This is Micheliana F2 and Flava Rugelli. It's an F2, so the F2 hybrids can get quite weird. The label is not staying in place. Okay. This is the mother of Saracenia Tempesta Nera, which is again a Micheliana mixed with a Flava Rugelli. The F1, this is F1, and this is the F2 of the same hybrid. It's quite an interesting plant. That's an alata mixed with the Leucophylla. That's another hybrid that I made. This is my monster flava. It looks like a maxima, but it's actually flava var flava. And this is a wild seed from Phil Wilson. This is a very old plant. This is a Saracenia called Glider mixed with Leucophylla. I have no idea, the Saracenia Glider, what kind of hybrid it is, but the main feature is that the lid is huge. It's absolutely huge, and every hybrid that has the glider in it have a huge lid. This is a beautiful a beautiful hybrid. It can get more colors on older leaves. So this is a very quick update on my Saracenia collection. This is Purpurea Sorrow. Purpurea Venosa Anthocyanin Free. Just a few psittacina. Yeah, this is the Saracenia Flava Ornata Dipping Lid. Getting big this year. So this is the update on the greenhouse. This is my vegetable garden that I'm preparing. I'm planting mostly vegetables from Veneto. Here I placed the radicchio trevigiano, which is a sicory from the city Treviso of the Venetian region. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 rows of Treviso radicchio, a piece of grass. This is a row of Castelfranco radicchio, where Castelfranco is another city of Veneto. And here I place some salad, and as you can see, the beans called Dolichos bean, I sowed them 48 hours ago and they are already breaking through the ground. Look. These were very old seeds. These seeds are 3 years old and they managed to do perfectly fine. Look at this. The whole row is, the ground is coming up. These are all the beans that are pushing the ground. And I think you can see some, maybe, here. No, I can't see anything. But they are pushing the ground up. I think I saw one plant earlier. Let's see if I can find it again. There you go. That's one. That's a bean. This is borragine, which is like some kind of spinach. I don't know how it's called in English. I'll put in the subtitles. Check the subtitles, please. And this is the part of the vegetable garden that I'm preparing right now. I'm gonna plant carrots and broccoli and everything for the winter. Here I have zucchini, the summer zucchini. I just sowed the winter zucchini. This is a zucchini I will keep for reproduction, so I'll keep the seeds from this zucchini for the next year. I always make my own seeds, always. I don't like to buy seeds. There are some zucchini. Tomorrow they'll be ready tomorrow to get. This is horseradish. I love horseradish. And I have the tomato, the little tomatoes here. They are almost ready. This is the heart-shaped small tomato. It's a very rare breed of tomatoes. And this is the wild round tomato. Very small, they are so sweet. And this is all for this year. I'll give you an update as soon as there is something that comes out of this soil.